she.
What the f***?
Oh, that's why he's destroying. He's what? Destroying the bush light, dude.
What?
Woo! Good job.
And he leaves to cheers. Okay. Cheers. Oh, all the beer is spilled. I have no idea why so interested in this particular case, but Justin, J Dustin, rather, D. Cain, the man seen smashing the beer in that viral video at a Walmart in Topeka, Kansas, has now been charged with exposing himself in public, according to Topeka police. The video has now been viewed over 5 million times. So much interest in this. The incident happened April 17, 9 p.m. at the Walmart located at 1501 Southwest Wanamaker Road, according to police. Officers learned that an adult male identified as J. Dustin D. Cain, 44, of Topeka, was in the store throwing things at people. A lot. Video of the incident, which ends with Cain being led out of the Walmart by police, was shared widely on social media, with some users suggesting that his actions may have been part of the wider boycott against brewing company Anheuser-Busch after one of its brands, Bud Light, partnered with trans influencer Dylan Mulvaney for promotion. That's all it was, folks, a promotion. Okay? Some even said Cain had destroyed the wrong beer by smashing up cases of Busch Light. But the product is also made by Anheuser-Busch. Police said Cain was arrested, charged with criminal damage to property, felony, battery, other charges, including exposing sex organs to another over the age of 16. Not clear if Cain's alleged exposure happened during the Walmart incident, and police have not disclosed a motive for the destruction of the beer. Bennie, react to the footage, but also our collective interest in it. 5 million views of this. Why?
Yeah, I mean, it really speaks to the moment because, like, look, like, we need to really, like, understand that that whole ad campaign with Dylan Mulvaney, it happened, like, almost 3 weeks ago now at this point. It was for March Madness. It was for March Madness. It is, we are, like, halfway through April, more than halfway through April, right? And so the right wing has completely lost its grip on reality because apparently just the reminder that a trans woman exists on a beer can is enough to send them into a frenzy. And I think one of the reasons why so many people are watching this right now is because, like, this is just a very clear moment of, like this conceptualizes, like, the entire right wing in this moment, where it's just this belligerent rage over something that has no effect on you by a person who himself is apparently accused of, was arrested for that indecent exposure, which is, like, literally what these people are trying to run around, like, calling people, like, calling queer people groomers and stuff like that. And it is just, like, it is just the peak fragile masculinity that drives the Republican Party. And, like, one of the things that just really gets these right-wingers upset about the existence of trans people, trans women in particular, and why it really hit close to home to them for this beer, like, on this beer can, is really because, like, fundamentally, they have this conception of masculinity as something that's inherently superior and deserving, and that femininity is something that they only tolerate because they view women as baby factories and useful to them, right? And so the idea of somebody, you know, like myself, a trans woman, saying, hey, actually, femininity is pretty cool and is actually desirable and has value in and of itself, already just undermines their entire identity, their complete sense of self-importance that's built on literally just misogyny. And then throw a picture of a trans woman on a beer can for one ad campaign, and then all of a sudden, what a lot of Americans think is a real symbol of masculinity, right? That is to say, beer. And all of a sudden, it's just a complete, utter collapse. And they feel like something that should be entirely centered towards them for a brief moment isn't centering them. And, like, it's just this complete identity collapse for the Republican Party. And most people don't care, right? The overwhelming majority of people don't care. But for the few people that do, they have lost their grip on reality and they have lost their ability to talk about or think about anything else, and it is honestly just speaks to how deeply unhinged the Republican Party is today and how deeply unhinged right-wingers more broadly are today in their weird fixation on trans people.
It is unhinged, and I don't know if they were ever based in reality to begin with, because the existence and the world order is built on a lie. So the minute you're right, Bennie, focus comes off, well, the lie becomes the truth to these people. And they start to, if you're buzzed anyway, what do you care? What do you care who's on the can? If you're sitting the idea with some of these people to get buzzed, leave people alone. Wow, I find it fascinating.